चैप्टर, तो चैप्टर 11 इट इज. ओके ओके यस ओके. प्रणव, व्हाट आर द फोर चेंबर्स ऑफ द हार्ट? प्रणव.
यस मैम, अपर चेंबर एंड लोअर चेंबर.
अपर चेंबर एंड लोअर चेंबर. ओके, कैन यू गिव मी द नेम फातिमा? द व्हाट आर द नेम ऑफ अपर चेंबर्स?
मैम आर्टरी.
आर्टरीज. आर्टरी, आर्टरी इज दैट मेन वन ऑफ द ब्लड वेसल. चेंज अपर चेंबर अनदर नेम अट्रियम. अट्रियम, atrium is the singular for one chamber and atria is the two chambers. Okay, yes. Irene, what do you call for lower chambers?
Ventricles.
So atrium and ventricles are the four chambers. Okay, apart from this Priyadatta, what does our heart has apart from four chambers? Apart from heart, sorry, apart from the chambers, what does a heart has?
Aorta.
What is aorta, Priyadatta?
Largest artery in the body.
Largest artery. Okay. Aaron, which is the major vein in the blood vessel? Major vein. Aaron, major vein. What do you call for it? Aorta, major artery, major vein. What do you call for
it?
Venakeva. Okay, venakeva. Okay, yes, venakeva. Shreya, last class you are present?
No, ma'am.
So you missed out. Okay, Naeem, do you you were present in the yesterday's class?
Yes, ma'am.
So what are the two venakevas? What we call two venakevas? Upper venakeva and lower venakeva, we call some other. Two venakeva, upper venakeva and lower venakeva, we call some other name.
Upper venakeva, superior.
Yeah. Superior venakeva and inferior venakeva. Okay. Yes. So Ahil, can you hear me? Ahil Mohammed, your video is not working, but can you hear me? Ahil, can you hear me? Only hardly 10 students. There is no more students over here. Abhaynath, can you hear me? Can you hear me, Abhaynath? Okay, shall I go back to Pranav? Pranav,
yes,
superior venakeva drain the blood from which parts of the body? Can you name the parts from where when superior venakeva bring the impure blood?
Ma'am, neck, arms and head.
Okay, neck, chest, head and then shoulders. Okay, yes. What about the inferior venakeva, Pranav? From where it will drain the impure blood? From which part of the body? Superior is from the upper part. So inferior will be, which are the parts included in that?
Legs.
Okay, legs. Then what you call our waist parts, we call another name starting with the P. What you call for that? Pelvis. Okay, so the waist parts including our sexual organs, we call pelvis. That is the pelvis. Okay, one more, abdomen. So the inferior vena cava drain the deoxygenated blood from pelvis, legs and abdomen, and superior vena cava drain the blood from neck, head, shoulder and all that. Okay, all this will be brought to the heart, then heart started pumping the blood. Okay, so this is what we have learned about the function of the heart. And Mohammed Faz, chapters in term 2, transportation, respiration. and we are coming to another thing is reproduction. All these three chapters, very important chapters. So those who miss the classes, go through the recorded version and study, and also read the textbook. Go to internet to understand the function of the heart, respiratory system, and circulatory system. Okay. Fatima, what do you call for one of the organisms which do not have any respiratory, which do not have any circulatory system? What is that?
Hydra.
Hydra. Anyone remember another one sponge. More organism with the hydra?
Sponge.
Sponge. Sponge and hydra. These are the microorganism. They do not have the circulatory system.
Mama, I cannot hear you.
Sebastian, maybe you are check your net. What about others? Can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Sebastian, others can hear you, hear me. And I don't know, maybe some network issues. Check on it. Okay. So, Abel, can you tell me how the circulate, without a circulatory system, how Hydra receives oxygen and expels carbon dioxide?
Mm.
Without any circulatory system, how Hydra receives oxygen and expels
water.
Abel, are you listening? Can you unmute and speak? Do you know? No. Okay. Aaron, repeat.
Ma'am, it's because Hydra doesn't have a circulatory system because it's living in the water. The water will supply the Hydra with oxygen and take the waste product out of them.
Okay. So, the Hydra, through the water, it receives oxygen, and also it expels carbon dioxide and waste materials through water. It has only one opening. Okay, children, now we are moving on to the next major part of this chapter. That is what you call excretory system. So today's date, you can write next heading, excretory system. So this is the last system of our body part, excretory system. So apart from carbon dioxide, after digestion, you already know, we have a process, ejection. So ejection mainly done by the excretory system. So even this diagram also you need to learn. Okay. And before that, I forgot to tell you something. Go to page number 125. Those who are textbook, can you go to page number 125?
Yes, ma'am.
So there is an activity for you to. Okay. By month of January, I wanted you to submit this activity. Very simple activity. Making a stethoscope by yourself. So everyone has to submit while the school reopens. Okay. And during the class time, online class, you can show off also. Before the December, very simple. Go to page number 125, activity 11.2. Activity 11.2, page number 125. I think you don't require much, time to make a stethoscope. This is a simple stethoscope which we can make out with a plastic funnel and one rubber tube. See, aquarium and all, we will use one. You can buy a plastic pipe to remove the water and all. So like that, you can buy maybe 1 meter or maybe 50 centimeter one rubber from plastic tube and buy the funnel. Funnel, you know what is that? In your home and all, the mother may be using to put the kerosene and oil in the bottle. You will get a plastic color funnel. You can buy for 20 rupees or something, you will get it. Okay. In Malayalam, what we call? We call it as...
What, ma'am? No.
No? Okay. Yes. Nihal, do you have the textbook with you? Nihal, Badi, Paul Hansel, where is Ausapachan? And Abel, Alan will not be there in the class. He's already taken TC. Okay. Alan Siju, you know that, no? I hope so. Anyone knows that Alan C. Jew has taken TC?
No.
Okay. Yes. No. Okay.
Yes,
okay.
Ma'am. I know.
You know it. Yeah. He must have called, you know. Okay. Priyadatta, can you read that activity 11.2, please? From the textbook.
Yes, ma'am. Take a small funnel of 6 to 7 centimeters in diameter. Fix a rubber tube 50 centimeters long tightly on the stem of the funnel. Stretch a rubber sheet on the mouth of the funnel and fix it tightly with a rubber band. Put the open end of the tube on your ears. Place the mouth of the funnel on your chest near the heart. Now try to listen carefully. Do you hear a regular thumping sound? The sound is that of your heartbeats.
Ma'am, her weed sound how is shattering.
Sebastian, I think you are having network issue, I think. Okay.
How many times did your heart beat in a minute? Count again after running for 4 to 5 minutes. Compare your observations.
Okay, children, so enough. So Priyadatta has read it. So read that act. Very simple thing. If you don't have rubber sheet, buy a balloon. A balloon, a plastic tube. You will able to buy from the plastic
and shop. What was the activity?
This is to
have done it once.
Make the stethoscope.
Yes.
Make what is stethoscope?
With plastic or
plastic may not be that much sound, may not tender. So what is stethoscope, Naeem? What is the use of stethoscope?
Ma'am, the doctors use it to see the heart rate, ma'am.
Heartbeat. The doctors are using. So you can make your own stethoscope by using a plastic funnel.
Ma'am, we have made it.
We have done it for.
You have done it in some classes. So again,
standard, not some classes.
Standard. So when you learn about this some system, okay. So you can. There is also one chapter breathing in. Okay, so you can do the same activity once again to understand. So make it and show it to be in the class. Okay, and January, I want all these things to be submitted in the class, in the school. Okay, when you come to the school. So this is another activity you have to make. Very simple thing. So you have done in fifth standard. Very easy. So one balloon is enough. One funnel is enough. One rubber tube, plastic rubber tube is enough. So that you can check your pulse rate. So once you come to the school, we can do activity with that. Okay. You can observe how many heartbeat you are having in 1 minute with that. Okay. So everyone, please make it. So that is the activity for second term activity for this also. There is marks. Already one activity I have given to you. That is about PPT presentation. Another one, so those who do not submit, no marks for it. Okay. So I am not repeating again and again about
I submitted, ma'am.
Yeah. Still, there are so many did not submit. So I don't go beyond behind you. Okay. Everything should be ready by January. Okay. So these two activities and there is a marks for it. Okay, children. So we go back to the excretory system. So human excretory system organs include, so which are the main excretory system? We have 4 important parts: a pair of kidneys, a pair of ureters, a urinary bladder and urethra. So these are the 4 major parts of excretory system. You can write the names, not fully, you can just write the parts of the excretory system. And in the picture it is clear. It's not so complicated, just like our heart, correct? Everything is clear. There are 2 kidneys, you can see on the top, and ureter. Ureter is that small pipe which is connected from the kidneys. And urinary bladder is a bowl-like shape and where the urine is get collected. Once urine is full, the brain will give you message to remove it. That is the time you are going to the toilet for urinating. Okay, so still that bowel is full, it will hold. Once the bowel is full, you have to expel it. So brain will stimulate you to go for it. So once you become old and all, if you don't take care of these kidneys and all, especially diabetic patient, this is the problem. Diabetes is something like that. They don't have the proper digestion. when they don't have the proper digestion, the kidney will not able to expel urine and feces, and this is how the sugar patients have a problem. Then they will undergo for a dialysis. Dialysis means the blood, they will be removed and purified and put it back again artificially. So this is because of the not functioning of excretory system. And you must have seen babies, you know, babies and old people. Those are old. These are the two categories. They are not aware of when they have to urinate. You see small babies, while they're born, they will urinate in the bed itself. Okay. Do you know that? Everyone knows. You also made it. While you are a small baby, maybe up to 1 year, 2 year old. Without controlling, you must have urinated on the birds, urinated on the body of your father, mother, sisters, everyone, aunties and all. Okay, everyone. So these are the two categories. You will not able to understand the brain message when to urinate. Okay. And old age people, you know, once they become old, they also lose their memory and they also urinate without knowing, they urinate on the bed. You know, some of the sick people. So these are the two categories. So the brain has to give you the stimulation to urinate. So babies and old people may not be aware of it. So these are the two things. So kidneys will drain the waste products, and they separate urine and feces separately. Urine will be passes through ureter from the kidney and collected in the urinary bladder. And the opening in female and the male, you have an opening for urinating that we call urethra. And the end of it, you will able to see urinary opening. So these are the main function. Very simple: pair of kidneys, pair of ureters, urinary bladder, urethra. So what is excretion? The process of waste produced in the cells of the living organism is called excretion. The process of waste produced. Okay. After digestion, there will be some waste products. That process we call it as excretion. The parts involved in excretion form the excretory system. So expelling excretion, what we call digestion. So that is what we have learned, digestion. The excreting or putting out, expelling the waste material, we call them digestion in the main thing. The major excretory product in human is urea. So all our feces, the number two, that is the major excretory product, we call it urea. Okay, urea. So some of the manure, we give the name urea. Okay, why? Because it is the waste material. That is what. So the major excretory product in human is urea, and the parts involved in excretion form the excretory system. Okay. Now we are going to see what is the function of each part. The first part we are going to learn, kidneys. Kidney is a mechanism to filter the blood, is done by the blood capillaries in the kidneys. So it is a mechanism to filter the blood. So kidneys is a mechanism to filter the blood and remove the waste material from the blood. So that is done by kidney. And who does this? The capillaries. So capillaries, you already learned in the previous class. There are three blood vessels: veins, arteries, and capillaries. And who helps the kidneys to filter the blood? Capillaries. Okay. So a mechanism to filter the blood is done by kidneys with the help of blood capillaries. Now, what is urinary bladder? That's already you know. The urine produced by the kidneys is stored in a bladder that is called urinary bladder. It's a storage house. Okay. Ureters. The waste dissolved in water are removed as urine from the kidneys. The urine goes into the urinary bladder through tube like ureter. So it is the tube which is carrying the urine to urinary bladder. That's all. Next is urethra. Urethra is stored in the bladder and is passed out through the urinary opening at the end of the muscular tube called urethra. So you know it is a opening of the thing. Okay, children, shall we move on?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, it's very simple, no? It's not so complicated like a heart. Kidneys, bladder, ureter, urethra. Now, what about our count of urinary portions? An adult human being normally passes about 1.8 liter of urine in 24 hours. That means if you are a normal and healthy boy or girl or man or woman, at least in one day, you will expel around 1.8 liters. That is 1 3/4 liters in 24 hours. And what is this urine consists of? The urine consists of 95% of water and 2.5% of urea and 2.5% of other waste products. Suppose some of the food materials contain some kind of waste which is not good for us. That also in the form of salt, we will be expelled. Okay, some of this waste is more in urinary content, then you will have the problem with the urinary infection. You also will see the salt in the urine, kidney stones. Have you heard about all the sicknesses? Kidney stones, the sugar in the sugar in the urine is more, salt in the urine is more. So all these things are some of the diseases. If you are not healthy enough and if you are having some kind of junk food, it will produce some problem like kidney stones or infection in urine. Then you will have a severe pain at the abdomen. Okay, so that is about it. Okay, children, so these are the things regarding excretory system. Okay, so whenever you have the food, you have to think and you have to eat what is enough for you. Otherwise, your respiratory system, blood circulatory system, digestive system, and excretory system, all the systems are connected. They will have somewhere or other, there will be problems. Okay, so the urine consists of 95% water, 2.5% urea, and 2.5% other waste products. And if other waste products are more in urine, naturally you will have urine diseases like, okay, and kidney related diseases. So that is the reason. Now, apart from this excretory system, we also have another one, that is what you call sweat. Okay. Sweat also is a part of waste product. Okay. No, Naeem. The sweat also have a particular smell. Okay, we have spoken later. And also, have you seen some of the body, they sweat, then the armpit of the wherever their dress is there, no? It will change the color. Have you ever seen that? Some of the people, those who sweat very, very much, slowly the dress what they are wearing, that also started decaying because of the presence of the acid content in that sweat. So what is sweat? Sweat contains water and some salt, and hence help in getting rid of toxic waste from the body. So apart from the urine, another way of excretory system is sweat, but we don't call it sweating is an excretory system, but another way of expelling the toxic waste means which is not good for our body. Also, as the sweat evaporates from our skin, it takes up our body heat, and this makes us feel cool. Okay, why we are sweating? Whenever you do a heavy work, the body started heating because lot of energy is used up. When you run, when you jump, when you play football, your body is using lot of energy. So because of the presence of energy, your body started heating. So the sweat is removing the heat energy in the form of evaporation. So that is how your body is getting cooled down. Otherwise, where we go, you come in the room, switch on the fan, and you will start making your body cool. Okay. So this is about the sweat. Okay, children, can I change the slide? Any more doubt yes, regarding this? Okay.
No.
Okay, no, it is not so much difficulty. Now we are moving on to excretion in animals. So, Priyadatta, can you read the board, the slide? 1 minute.
Yes, ma'am.
Read.
The way in which waste chemicals are removed from the body of the animal depends on the availability of water. Aquatic animals like fishes excrete cell waste as ammonia, which directly dissolves in water.
Okay, Priyadatta, stop it. 1 minute. Okay, children. So, in excretion animals, how it is? It is depending upon how much water is in our body. You see, like we human being, will the birds will go and urinate every time? Will the animals go urinate every time? Have you seen the cows are urinating like us every now and then? Have you seen? They urinate, but not like us. Maybe one time or two times. But we human beings can go every one period. After some people will say, ma'am, shall I go to toilet? That is not because you want to urinate. You just want to escape. No? Naeem, correct? Some of the, when you are a small, every time. And especially you are a small kid, no? First standard, second standard. Ma'am?
Ma'am, not me like also.
This. Miss? This is not ma'am. That they wanted to urinate. They want to come. They want to come out of the class and go to the toilet side, and there will be some of your friends and chit chat and come up. Girls also. Ma'am, shall I go to toilet? Okay. So that is the nature of the human being. Even you are not wanted, also you will go. But cows, animals will not do. Elephant also did not do. Have you seen the movies of that Jay Suryas? Yeah. For collecting the urine of the elephant, how much? It's a funny movie, but still you can see that they are waiting for elephants to urinate and also to give you the feces also. Animals are like that, but we are not like that. Even though not wanting, go for excretion. So this is something our nature and the human, the other nature. So animals, excretory system works depending upon how much water they have in your body. They don't drink water, but we human beings need to drink a lot of water, then only our body will work. Okay, so that is the thing. And another thing is that fishes, what is the name of that waste produced by fishes? Ammonia. Ammonia is a chemical substance and it is very good manure also. Okay. That is why the plants near the river basin, the trees will grow very well, because the waste products excreted by fishes and marine species, it is an ammonia. Ammonia is a natural manure from the fishes. We make ammonia artificially, but what we get it from the river, it is a natural ammonia. Okay, so that is also very good for growing the trees. Okay. Okay, Pranav, read the next 2 lines. Second one, third one.
Sometimes animals like birds, lizards, snakes excrete a semi-solid white colored compound, uric acid.
Yes. Okay. Wait, Pranav. So you see the crows, it's very common, no? Crows, sometimes crows waste will fall on our body, and you can see it has a very foul smell, and it is also is in a white in color. Okay, why? Because it contains a compound uric acid. That is why smell is so hard, you cannot bear. You just run to wash it off. Okay, because it contains a uric acid. The crows, pigeons, and also there's a foul smell, any type of lovebirds, whatever, their waste product is a semi-solid white in color, mixing with it, because it contains a chemical compound, uric acid. Okay, so that is about excretion animals. These are the 3 important features related to excretion in animals. One is their excretory system works on the basis of availability of water. Second one, aquatic animals like fishes and excrete organism ammonia, that is their excretory product. And we human being is urea, And birds and lizards and snakes, their excretory product is known as uric acid. Okay, last one, dialysis.
Dialysis. Some persons cannot die unless their life is filtered periodically through an artificial kidney due to infection or injury. This process is called dialysis.
Okay, so this is what is mainly dialysis done in sugar patients. There will be time come sugar patients cannot live without dialysis. That is, from their body, excretory system fully closed up. Okay, because my mother also now living on the basic dialysis. Every week after alternative days, my mother, we are giving dialysis because she is a highly sugar patient. Once dialysis stops, my mother will go to heaven. So that is the situation now. I'm telling you that. So every week, three times, my mother is going for dialysis alternative day because she lost the the working of excretory system. So children, so by this I'm winding up the session. So I'm telling all this, be careful while you are having junk food. Now nothing will affect you. Nothing will affect you. Reduce intake of the food which contain lot of fat. Okay, non-veg items, and also included some vegetable item, because the reason is behind is that now no problem when you go after 30 and all, you prone to diabetes, and after that your life will become like my mummy's. Okay, I'm just telling my real life experience. So once we stop dialysis, I will lose my mother in my life. That is the condition. So that is dialysis. Okay.